her. My name is Mama Fish, the new girl. I'm here tonight because a friend of mine thought it might be good to join a single parent support group. I'm really not sure where to begin. Things would be so much easier if German was still here. But then I wouldn't have Burelle, would I? Let me back up. This all started a few months ago. My friend Gina invited me for coffee. She works for Child Protective Services, the sweetest person you'd ever meet.
You just need to shut your pie hole and listen, Stan. You did not see what I saw. No way was I going to leave that girl there another day. Well, no, she's in a shelter. I haven't found a place for her yet. Your itinerary is your problem, Stan. Not my circus, not my monkey. These kids are too important to give anything less than my best. So if my best interferes with your precious itinerary, Stan. Anyway, I'm meeting with a lady about it today. She just doesn't know it yet. Oh, I gotta go. Wanda?
Gina?
How are you, sweetie?
I'm getting by.
This is a cute little place. You live right upstairs? Man, if I lived above a place like this, I would never creep again. Then again, I'd be a whole lot thicker, too. She looks great.
You're too kind.
Maybe I should try the whole vegetarian thing. God knows I can stand to lose a few pounds. How are things, sweetie?
Things have been tough.
Oh, I know.
No, you don't. I mean, you want to, but you can't. You can't really know until you do it yourself.
No, I'm sure you're right. You been keeping busy?
I have to. It's been over a year now, and it's quiet. I mean, I have to really focus on what I'm working on, because if I don't, then I just shift into autopilot. I think that's what hurts the most. I still get so angry. I mean, I know he died saving that little girl's life, but at what cost?
You know, sweetie, it may not seem fair, but he didn't die.
He was my hero, too. If you want to hear something else, this is going to sound real bad.
Why don't you try?
Some days, I'm almost relieved you lost the baby. I mean, I know it sounds awful, it's difficult to say. I just don't think I've done that. Raising a child all by myself.
I'm sure it would have been hard for you. Now, this may not be the best time to bring it up, but I really think you should consider foster care.
Gina, we have talked about this before. It's not that I haven't thought about it. Just I'm not ready.
I know. You'll get there. You will. Actually, I've been thinking about this new girl. She's 16. Cute kid. Kind of goofy.
I'm black goofy.
Well, then you'll think you hit the jackpot. Her mom died a few years back. Mom's boyfriend helped raise her, but he was an alcoholic, so that didn't work out.
Do you really think I might be what she needs?
I don't know, sweetie. She might be exactly what you need.
So, that's how it all started. I was still nervous, not knowing if I had it in me to be a good foster mom or not. But I figured if this little girl needed some love and nurturing, then I could do that. So I agreed, and I soon met Burelle. And last, but certainly not least, the final stop on our grand tour is, drum roll please, your new bedroom. Cute, right?
What's with all the baby stuff?
I don't know, some paint, a few posters. This could be a really cool place. Come to think about it, I might move in here instead of you.
Yeah, maybe you should.
I know it's not much, but this is a good place, okay?
Like the last place or the place before that?
What do you expect? I mean, nothing's permanent.
No kidding.
No, what I meant is we can change pretty much anything you like. Do you like music?
Is that what this is? Some kind of stereo or something?
That was mine when I was your age. It's a ghetto blaster.
Mixtape. I don't know. This thing kind of makes my brain hurt just looking at it.
I wanted to get you some music, but I wasn't really sure what you liked.
I like oldies.
What type of oldies? Elvis? The Beatles?
The Who?
The Who, they all agree.
know. Really? For a lady in her 80s, you sure don't look a day over 70.
Oh my god!
What do you say it?
Clowns! I'm terrified of clowns!
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I didn't know. I didn't.
Neither did I. Okay. It's gone now.
I guess there's a lot we don't know about each other. But you know what? I'm excited to learn. And if you want to know anything about me, anything at all, just ask. Ask me anything. Anything at all.
What's for dinner?
How does a nice cauliflower loaf sound?
Odd.
Gina did mention I'm a vegetarian, didn't she?
You're kidding me.
I don't eat anything I may have to apologize to in the afterlife.
No meat, like, at all? Are you trying to kill me?
Trust me, you won't even miss it. Maybe we'll fry up some okra.
Wait, you don't eat meat, but you eat whale?
I think you're thinking of orca, not okra. Miss Gina told me you like to cook. What else do you like?
I like to write songs and poems.
Is that what you want to be when you grow up? A writer?
And a fashion designer. I have my own clothing line.
I like Burelle Originals.
Burelle Originals. Hey, I like that. I'm gonna write that down.
Maybe we can dress up sometime and have a fashion show?
I don't know. Most of the clothes I have don't fit anymore.
I think the shelter's sending some clothes over in a day or two.
It's the clothes of the shelter that don't fit no more.
Oh, well, what do you have that does fit? Okay, well, let's have a look, shall we? Let's see here. We've got shirt. I saw another shirt in here. These are pretty. Oh, a pair of jeans.
Oh, those are my favorites. The zipper don't work no more, but they're like a $60 pair of jeans.
Okay, well, here's the thing. They don't work. We are not going to keep them. What else do we have? Oh, flip-flops. Now, when I was your age, you call these things thongs.
No way.
Way? Granted, that was a long time ago.
Kind of funny though, because with flip-flops, the strappy thing goes in between your toes, but in a thong, the strappy thing goes
okay.
in between your
toes. Okay, you've been on. I've got a bra. What sock? Panties.
Don't touch that, that's personal.
What, panties?
My pictures.
Okie dokie. And duct tape. What's this for?
I make stuff.
What kind of stuff?
All kinds. Like this one time I made a wallet, another time a belt. Hey, you know the duct tape people are doing this contest thing for like prom dresses and stuff? I never tried to make a dress, but I think I could do it.
It's too bad not everything in life can be fixed with duct tape, huh? Well, you know what? It's not much, but it's a start. I'll bet you like to shop, don't you?
Sure.
And I'll bet you like tea parties, too.
Maybe when I was like 5.
I can't wait. There's so much we can do. We can do each other's hair. We can go shopping. Wait, I got a pedicure. My toes look like I should be snatching fish from a river. I just can't wait. There is so much. Starting with tomorrow morning, I'm going to teach you how to appreciate the perfect cup of coffee.
Seem to go nowhere. I've lost my life, 'cause I toss and turn, I can't sleep at night. Once I ran to you.
So I was always taught to say excuse me, even if you think no one heard you, 'cause they can probably still smell it.
Probably. Good morning, my beautiful, please. So what is your favorite jitter juice?
I'm not really supposed to have any coffee on account of all the medication I'm on.
Is that so?
No word of a lie. Hey, what's a grande?
Oh, English muffins?
I don't know. I like muffins.
Two English muffins and orange juice. Thanks. So we meet with your school counselor at 11.
Any chance we can skip it?
Pray not. You go with one English muffin and an orange juice.
This doesn't look like a muffin.
Right, you might like it.
Doubtful.
So I have taken a whole day off so we can spend it together. What shall we do?
We could talk in British accents all day.
That does sound delightful now, doesn't it?
Jesus Murphy, you speak British.
But of course, it's only my second language.
Really?
No, not really.
We could go to the mall, talk all British and stuff. People would think we were famous.
Maybe disco dancing.
Ooh, I like to boogie, I like the nightlife.
Perhaps a spot of tea.
Oh no, I do not like tea. Maybe a spot of vanilla ice cream instead.
Trust me, you do not want to eat vanilla ice cream.
Wanna bet?
Okay, I read somewhere where they use the secretions from the rear ends of beavers to give it that musky taste.
Beaver butt juice? That's just nasty.
Maybe we can get some sorbet. There's a cherry berry froyo place in my store.
Which reminds me, I need to stop by there and pick a few things up. Like carpet things?
Carpet.
Well, you said you were a florist, right?
Well, a sweetheart florist don't do floors, we do flowers.
How do you mean you do flowers?
Okay, well, you know how you're all creative with your poems and songs and such?
Yeah.
That's me with flowers. I get pretty creative when I'm in the flow.
Yeah, that happens to me too. I'll just be sitting there, and all of a sudden I'll just start getting creative. Oh, crap.
What is it?
I think I just, you know, started.
I think that's pretty darn awesome. Don't stop.
What?
You might find you really like it.
Are you for serious?
I know it can be tough now, but what you're producing could be the beginnings of something really beautiful.
Beautiful? No, I don't know about that.
Trust me, as a creative woman myself, I know. I mean, it starts deep down inside of you, and then it starts to swirl and bubble its way to the surface, and before you know it, it just comes pouring out of you.
You're right.
I know.
I think it's about to start pouring out of me right now.
That's awesome. Don't stop.
What?
Okay, and don't settle for a trickling brook either. Think not ever fall. I mean, I know it can be difficult, especially with an audience watching.
Oh, wow.
That's when I just close my eyes and let it build and flow naturally. Oh, and don't be afraid to get your hands messy either.
Oh my gosh, that is so gross.
What's gross?
Please tell me we're talking about two totally different things.
I'm talking about being creative.
I'm talking about starting my period.
So they painted my office over a week ago, and the fumes are still just terrible. But this is where I spend most of my time anyway.
Oh, it's a stage.
Hey, you're a quick one, aren't you? But this isn't just a stage, sister. This is a theater.
Oh, like movies and stuff?
Oh, not just movies. Big elaborate stage productions. I'm talking sets, costumes, the fourth wall. Think about it. Expand your mind. A stage is the perfect home of creative expression. A safe haven for the product of a beautiful mind.
You're on medication, aren't you?
Just a bit of a drama geek.
No kidding.
Pardon?
I mean, no kidding.
It's a passion of mine, eh? Theater's the reason I left Canada for the States.
They made you leave? You must have been pretty awful.
Classically trained, with a bit of comic flair.
Oh yeah, kind of like a bullet.
So you're an actor?
Well, used to be. Now I teach and direct, run the drama club.
A drama teacher and a guidance counselor. Interesting.
Interesting as in stimulating, exciting, captivating? Would you like to get to know more about, perhaps?
Interested as in interested.
Well, one thing I've learned, Miss Fish, is that a good director knows how to guide his cast. From the rise of the curtain, through the comedy, the drama, the mystery, intrigue, through every plot twist and turn and conflict, until we reach a rich and satisfying, ending? Ending, right. An And isn't that what we want in life, too?
A happy ending?
Oh, not every story has a happy ending, Miss Fish. But hopefully, at least a satisfying one. Besides, it's not all about the ending, but the journey on the way. That's what makes a good story. I mean, think about it. It just makes sense, don't it?
I suppose.
Burelle?
Mm-hmm.
You enjoy jokes, eh?
Sure.
Well, you'll like this one. What did the nosy pepper do?
I give up.
He got jalapeno business! Get it?
Not completely.
It's a jalapeno pepper. He gets jalapeno business. Jalapeno business. You get it, right, Miss Fish? Please explain it to her later. Okay, so tell me, Burelle, what should I know about you?
Well, most of the time I'm just trying to ignore the voices in my head, but they can be pretty funny. So if you see me laughing for no reason, that's probably why.
Voices. Right. It's a jalapeno pepper. Still nothing.
Is it a Canadian joke? I mean, maybe it's just Canadian humor I don't understand, eh?
You know, it was Sister Corita Kent who said, to understand is to stand under, which is to look up, which is a good way to understand.
Yeah, I knew you were on medication.
So what about the classes?
Tell you what. Burelle, there's a vending machine just down the hall. How about you run and get us some pops? Give Wanda and I a moment to talk.
Cool beans.
I'll take a Pepsi, please. Anything for you, Miss Fish?
No, thanks. Mutual gratefulness de casa.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what I just said there.
I think you almost said thank you to the house in Spanish.
Really? See? Told you I could speak Spanish.
Cute kid. How long has she been with you?
Not even a full day.
And I'm assuming you haven't seen her school records yet?
No, I haven't. Why?
Burelle has a lot of gaps.
The gaps? Is that bad?
That depends, Miss Fish. If you see something you want, and there's space between you and that something, you want to close in and fill that space.
Well, I'll be asking you to close those gaps in, don't we?
We sure do, but don't worry, she's in excellent hands.
Yes, I can see you have excellent hands.
Sorry?
I'm your teaching staff.
Oh, of course. So, is there a Mr. Fish, Miss Fish?
No, not anymore, I'm afraid.
I see.
Perhaps that's a conversation for another time.
I'd like that very much.
Ew. Gross.
But I don't know where I'm going.
That Mr. Clawson was kind of cute. I think he was flirting with me just a little. Not that I was ready for anything like that, though. So I took Burelle shopping. We bought some really cute things. Some oldies music like Bon Jovi and Hall & Oates. We've been in a chick flick, a bonnet movie, and even though it was the end of our first day together, I had a feeling that we were really bonding. That Jane Austen was the bomb.
Yeah.
Which one was she again?
She wasn't in the movie, she wrote the book.
Oh, yeah, I knew that. And yeah, she was way bomb.
You know the way you like to write, you could be the next Jane Austen.
Oh, I don't know about that. It'd be too much trouble to change my name.
Can I take the Kleenex? Because I always cry at that one, too.
I wasn't crying. I just had a allergy box in my eyeballs. I'm sure it was just your laundry soap or something.
I doubt that. It's hyperallergenic. It's good for you, good for the environment.
You know, I don't understand why people aren't more respecters of the environment. I mean, we still use oil, which kills our ozones. And we need those ozones to live. They're like giant sunglasses protecting us from the ultraviolence.
I think you mean ultraviolence.
No, I mean ultraviolence!
You know, like, Chai Chi?
Okay, I think you mean Tai Chi. What's the difference?
One's yummy and sweet, and the other's sweaty and salty.
Anywho, they also give us stuff like headaches and statistical cancer. I mean, in guys, of course, since obviously women don't have statisticals.
Okay.
You should put one of these in your car. Like, hanging from my rear view mirror? Yeah, I don't think so. And someone should really start putting prizes in these boxes. Like, hey, we know your period sucks, so here's a coupon of the cherry berry. You know, or something like that.
That is an idea.
So, can I look at my school schedule?
Yeah, it's on the counter. I think we got some really great deals today. I especially love this one.
Son of a monkey!
What is it? What's the matter?
That's it. I'm not going. I mean it. I'm not going.
Great. Just wait a minute. Calm down.
They think I'm stupid.
They don't think that.
Yeah, they want to give me a tutor in algebra.
So what's the matter with that?
Everything's the matter with that. It's embarrassing. And they want to put me in freshman biology. I mean, that's science, right? Can you believe that? Science is the one subject I'm actually good at. Neutrons and protons.
Well, now just think how far ahead you'll be in the rest of the class. You can help the teacher.
Help the teacher? Are you for serious?
It's okay to be a little behind. You moved a lot. Your teachers know that. You'll have it back in no time.
It's just perfect. Safe to say I'll never be valedictorian at this rate.
It's safe to say. But think of how incredible you'll be in drama class. Which one do you want to wear your first day?
I always wear my hoodie.
Okay, there's no law against that yet. But I think you need to make a good first impression.
I said I always wear my hoodie.
But surely you don't mean always.
Always. Did I stutter?
Fine, Simma. If you're going to wear it, I at least want a clean. Give it to me now and you can have it back in the morning.
What? sneak up on me like that.
Sorry, bad ninja. You're up kinda early.
Couldn't sleep. Birds were talking to me.
What do you mean they were talking to you?
You know, they kept saying, chirp, chirp, the sky's awake, you should be awake, chirp, chirp. I mean, I guess they could have been talking to somebody else. Not really sure on that.
Where do you come up with such interesting ideas?
I don't know. Lenny Kravitz records, maybe?
Why do I smell butter?
Oh, that would be the cooking spray.
Okay. Why are you spraying cooking oil in here?
Because I ran out of regular oil.
Oh, Burelle is everywhere! Why did you do this?
Well, I thought you were trying to pass the demon last night, so I anointed my room. Rule number one in getting rid of the demons is you have to anoint the joint. Turns out you're only snoring, but a girl can never be too careful. So, what's for breakfast? Not those English thingies again.
You mean English muffins?
Yeah. I mean, no offense to the English people, I just don't really care for their foods.
How about cereal?
As long as it's not English cereal. Oh my gosh, okay. So you know how I hate spiders, right?
Not really.
Okay, well let me tell you I do. So I'm in the shower, pee, and then I look up.
Back up. Did you say you were peeing in the shower?
What? Too much TMI? I mean, I guess I don't really want to know about all your weird peeing rituals either. So anyway, I'm in the shower peeing, and then I look up, and there's this big mahoosive spider on the wall just mean mugging me, and then I get him squashed down, like, in the drain, but the rest of the time, I'm totally paranoid it's gonna, like, crawl back after me.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
Look, just don't pee in the shower, okay?
Okay.
So, change of subject, I was thinking we could talk about what happened last night.
I don't want to talk about it.
I believe I owe you an apology.
Well, in that case...
Look, I know coming here this isn't your first rodeo, but it's mine.
Actually, I've never been to a rodeo.
It's just an expression.
Yeah, with horses, right? I know what a rodeo is, I've just never been to one.
Anyways, I'm going to try really hard to get things right, but I'm also going to get things wrong, too.
Your point?
My point is I'm here to help you with whatever may lie ahead.
What lies? Who's lying to me now?
Never mind. What is that smell?
You mean the butter spray?
No, it's something else. It's something kind of fruity.
Oh, you know those tampons you bought me the other day? The Fresh Secrets?
Yeah.
Well, I shoved a bunch in the socks.
In your socks?
Yep.
I guess that's not a bad idea.
Wait a minute, turn around.
What? You've got something on you.
Oh my gosh, it's a spider! Get off! Get off! Get off!
You had a sticker on your jeans.
Oh, you mean I could have had that on my booty all day?
You could have said it was a fashion statement. Speaking of fashion statements, I was saying that maybe after school we could get you some new hoodies. Maybe exchange your clothes for something you can actually wear.
Okay.
Great. I know this custom printing shop that lets you do your own graphics.
Like Burelle Originals?
Maybe we can do a few ourselves. I've always considered myself very artistic.
Yeah, I kind of thought that about you too. Like Rain Man, right?
Artistic. Anyway, I emailed your counselor last night. He wants to meet with you at lunch today.
About what?
I don't know, maybe go over your schedule, talk about what happened last night.
I knew it. Are you gonna be there too?
Well, maybe. I said I was his if he needed me.
Ugh, so gross.
You and I in a little toy shop.
I hate my freaking teachers. I hate them, I hate them, I hate them.
Tell me how you really feel.
I can't do this.
Can't do what?
All of this. School, life, it's just stupid.
It's all how you look at stuff.
Oh yeah, Albert Grindstone. What makes you such an expert?
I've been listening to it for a long time. I'm not telling you anything you haven't heard before.
Yeah, I've heard it all. Over and over and over again.
Think positive. Be positive. Yada, yada, yada. Blah, blah, blah.
Maybe that's the thing. See, you've been hearing it, while I've been listening to it. There's a difference, you know.
Yeah, well, I think it's stupid.
I used to think so, too. Then one day it just made sense, you know.
Why are we even talking about this anyway?
Maybe it's because you need someone to listen to you and not just hear you.
Yeah, right.
I know you better than you think. You're unhappy.
Doesn't take a rocket surgeon to figure that out.
You feel like you got a raw deal. Then you probably did.
No kidding.
Or rise up, take control of your life.
Reach it, brother.
But you've got no real control. See, life is moving in 100 different directions. Well, you're stuck in one simple place.
Feels just like that.
So, instead of sticking out, which you easily could do, you try hard to blend in. Go unnoticed, like a total melvin.
Pretty much.
You're insecure, but you know how to play the game. And you like it here.
What? On stage? I mean, guess so.
It's a good place to use your imagination. I mean, here, you could be whoever you want to be. And I could be whoever you want me to be.
Who do you think I want you to be?
I don't know. Maybe a cowboy. Howdy, ma'am. How's about you and me and mosey on down to the end of the world, and we'll watch sun and moon play leapfrog? Yeehaw!
What does that even mean?
I don't reckon I know much. Sounds cowboyish, figure.
Try again.
Okay. How's about we move south of the border? Hola, señorita. I, Señor Butchies, welcome you to my grand opening.
That's gross.
Yes, yes it is. It's very gross. Stunning rites of princess, all handsome and glistening with sweat. Come, milady, ride on my noble steed, where I shall slay the fiercest dragons in order to win the princess's heart. That's beautiful.
Surely you jest.
I would not bequeath a maiden of such high stature with a clever ruse.
Then by what name shall I call on thee, my good and noble hero?
Sir Joshua Washington Esquire. But you, milady, may call me Joshua. Perhaps the fair maiden will honor thee with a kiss?
I'd rather kiss your noble steed.
My loss, I'm certain. Sounds like first lunch is over.
Oh, crap. I was supposed to go meet with my counselor today. Probably shouldn't be caught talking to you either.
Then I meet thee good morrow, please.
Ah, Miss Washington. I've been looking all over for you.
Well, you found me.
Heard you had quite an issue last hour.
I don't want to talk about it.
Making fun of Elizabeth Burns?
I wasn't making fun of her.
Oh, really? And what would you call it?
I thought she was doing a cheer, you know, and I tried to join in.
Burelle, the girl is deaf. That was sign language.
I realize that now, and that's why I evacuated.
I'm sorry, you did what?
Ran, did the splits. You sure don't speak the English very well, do you, Mr. Thania, eh?
Well, did you forget about our lunch meeting?
I didn't forget. I just had to get away from all the drama for a minute.
So you came to the drama room. Well, your mother should be here shortly.
She's not my mother.
Sorry, Miss Fish should be here any minute now. How do I look?
Fine, I guess. Why? Here you are.
Yes, here we are. Please come in.
Hello, Mr. Clausen.
Please call me Blake.
Can I call you Blake, too?
No.
I'm so glad you can meet us on such short notice. Did we miss lunch?
Oh, no, I was just about to grab a candy bar or something. I'm really glad he contacted me. I just didn't expect it to be.
Why are you glad she contacted you? The sooner, the better, I suppose. Oh, my holy snap, I get it.
Well, Miss Fish.
Oh, you like each other, Columbanda, don't you, Burelle? You do, don't you?
Burelle.
I'm just saying.
So, I took the liberty of speaking to Burrell's morning teachers. They really like you.
They sure don't know me very well yet. You may not know this, but, I got a few issues.
Really? They don't show.
Smooth on the outside, but on the inside, kinda nutty. Like a candy bar.
Like a really great candy bar. Okay. Speaking of which, remember that vending machine down the hall? Why don't you run and get us a couple? Let Wanda and I talk privately.
Again? Disgusting.
Mama!
So, maybe she's right.
Right about what?
Maybe you do like me.
Excuse me?
I mean, I suppose I could be reading into things.
Okay, what things?
Well, for instance, this is only, what, your second day together? What serious problems could she really be having so early on?
Okay, I don't know what serious problems is then, but you should have heard the way she was yelling at me last night. She can't be doing that.
Well, did she?
Did she what?
Did she yell at you?
Yes.
Well, then apparently she can be doing that.
But she shouldn't.
Well, of course she shouldn't. That's just mad, right?
Right. But.
Yes, and.
Pardon?
Yes, and. Oh, see, it's one of the silly rules of theater. When you reply with yes, but, that's conflict. Now, if you want to have a conversation with someone, you reply with yes, and, so you can build on what the other person said. It's less confrontational. Unless, of course, you do want to have an argument.
Okay, I'm lost. What are you talking about?
Burelle is a person, right?
Right.
Just like you, right?
Right.
And not only are you a person, you are also immature, attractive, well-rounded, rationally thinking adult.
Yes, but...
Yes, and. She's entitled to her own opinions, just as you are, right?
Well, yes, but...
Yes, and. You've created for yourself a safe environment to express those feelings, right?
Yes, but... And...
There you go. Now, don't you think that's what she wants too? Maybe she's trying to feel you out. Push your buttons. Maybe she wants you to push back. Or maybe she's not a rebellious teenager at all. It could be she's never learned how to express herself appropriately. Maybe she needs a safe zone.
So, what are you saying? Like, a sounding board, you're saying I just need to let her vent.
Within boundaries.
Maybe you are smarter than I gave you credit for.
Well, I can't depend on charm for everything, now can I?
Okay, old people. I'm back in the room now.
Maybe we can get together sometime for some coffee.
I'd like that.
I knew it. I knew you liked each other.
So it's been a few months, and Mr. Clausen and I have been meeting regularly for coffee. And I really enjoyed having a man back in my life. Not that I was ready to go to on coffee shop dates yet. And as for Burelle, well, let's just say things haven't exactly been smooth sailing. Hi, Gina. It's just coffee. I know it's okay. I'm just not ready yet, right? Burelle?
What can I say? I feel like I'm turning into my mother. Which is strange because I don't even like my mother that much.
I know she misses you and she would love to see you.
Yes, I know lots of kids to see. It's just I really just need to talk to someone.
I've gotta go, okay?
I miss you too.
Bye.
Here we go. Your Colombian Giraldo Exotico, double shot espresso, 1 pump vanilla, 2 pumps caramel, soy frappe with chocolate sprinkles and hazelnut drizzle venti.
Perfect! And what are you drinking?
Coffee. Just plain black coffee.
Not being adventurous today?
Funny. That's exactly what the barista asked.
Barista?
Yeah, the woman at the counter.
Oh, is that what her name is?
What?
Cute little Miss Barista over there, shaking all her hot stuff.
No, a barista is what you call the person who serves your coffee.
Come on, Blake, seriously?
Yep.
Really?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Well, if I didn't know any better, I think I detected a hint of jealousy.
Me? Jealous?
Deny it all you want. I know what I heard.
You, sir, are crazy.
That may be. But don't let my choice of drink fool you. In fact, I'm feeling very adventurous. Tonight, I'm thinking Ochoa's Veggie Tacos followed by a movie. Perhaps you'll join me.
Your Jedi mind tricks won't work on me. Besides, last time I went to a movie theater, I passed gas. 4 guys turned around and I felt like I was all voice.
All right then. No movie, just Ochoa's. What do you say?
Look, Blake, you're a real nice guy.
Oh, why do I feel a big butt coming?
No buts. And I really enjoy our coffee shop dates.
As do I.
So is it okay if we just keep it that way?
yeah, this is great. Besides, I've only just gotten your usual memorized.
And it's delicious.
So, how's work been? Business picking up this week?
Thank God, weddings and funerals. Can't depend on husbands and boyfriends to put food on my table.
Just how many husbands and boyfriends do you have?
You know what I mean. No one sends flowers anymore.
You should think about hiring out Burelle as a singing telegram.
Like a Burellegram?
Yeah.
Have you heard her sing? She sounds like a walrus giving birth to farm equipment.
So I guess things are good at home then.
I wouldn't say that.
All right, what would you say?
I'd say that the honeymoon's over.
Want to talk about it?
Big mood swings like a roller coaster ride.
Are you taking anything for it?
Not me, her. Don't get me wrong, we have some really good days. We also have some really bad days, too. Curse rolling things. Again, her. Not me. Okay, well, maybe me sometimes. I have no idea what I'm doing.
I'm a teacher, Wanda. I know how teenagers can be.
So you're saying this is typical teenage behavior? Last night, she got mad because her dry erase marker quit right on toast.
We both know Burrell's not exactly typical.
She broke the Star Wars mug you gave me.
Maybe it couldn't handle the force. Look, just keep leading by example. She'll come around eventually. Unless she's crazy. You can't fix crazy. Not without Abilify. Or lithium. Tokamex, perhaps.
I hear her talking to herself in her bedroom. Does that count?
It's not like she has any friends, Wanda.
Fred, but I have to be her parent too. I just don't think I'm doing either one very well.
It could be you're trying to fix something that's not broke. You know, I see all these other kids. They all look the same, talk the same, hiding who they really are. Because that's what they're trained to do. They'll grow up and have kids of their own and raise them the same way. And the cycle just continues. But not Burelle. Somehow she managed not to drink the Kool-Aid.
No, she's a whole new flavor of Kool-Aid. I like that she's unique, and I try to humor her. But I just keep wondering if I'm doing her any favors. One day she's going to end up with a job, and her boss is going to expect her to perform the same as everyone else does. But they won't put up with the little obviousities. They won't care that she talks to birds. They won't see her the way I do.
How do you see her?
Besides being mentally interesting, she's creative. She's unique. She's Falco.
Wait, you had me and then you lost me.
Oh, come on, Falco. Rock me all the days. Rock me all the days. Look at that. It is only like the coolest song ever. I don't even know what it means. I mean, no one does. That's just it. It's creative, it's unique, and I love it. I'm just not sure how much longer I can put up with it. When this whole thing started, I was all about being creative and nurturing. Here I thought was a little girl who just needed to hear the words, I love you.
Oh my holy snap. After all these years, no one has ever said those three magic words to me. Do you realize what this means? Now I can finally get my life straight. I mean, pull my act together. My future suddenly looks so freaking bright. High school graduation, college, my own theme song. Look out, world, here comes Burelle, the strong, proud, independent woman. No more peeing in the showers for me, all because of this woman. Stand up, WandaFish, stand up and take your vow. She loves me and I love you.
But I could not have been more wrong.
This is why I hate this place!
I'm not sure how much more of this I can take. I mean, we shouldn't fight all the time. It shouldn't be hard. I love her, but I don't think I can do this anymore. So here's what I'm thinking. I will call Gina. I will call Gina and put an end to this whole thing like it never happened. Okay, can I? The very next text I get is from Gina, Burelle's start to swell up, and I realize things have just gotten a whole lot more complicated. Shout and go to the darling, you give love a bad name. Ow!
Love you.
Sure doesn't feel like it.
Then maybe you need to reevaluate.
evaluate what you think love is? Because obviously, somewhere down the line, somebody has really messed your perception.
Hey, my daddy loved me.
Your daddy was a drunk, Burelle. He didn't care about anybody else but himself.
Stop it.
No, really, what do you think he was thinking every time he finished off a bottle? Gee, I sure do love that Burelle. Get me another beer, will you, girl?
Stop it, please.
Your daddy was a selfish drunk, and that's all he cared about was himself!
Please, don't talk about him like that.
Burelle, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but I think one day your mom will
have- You are not my mom, okay? You can't even be a mom. That's probably why your baby died.
Could you just wait a minute?
So you wait a minute. Your baby's roasting in hell, and that's where you'll be too whenever you finally die, which I hope is very soon.
Well, I realize I was out of line, but that was probably the meanest, most hurtful thing anyone has ever said to me. So you know what? Congratulations. I'm gonna go to my room before I say something else